welcome, everyone. It is really good to see so many old friends here. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Geriatric. Well, I guess even if you do know me, I'm still Geriatric. It's Geri with a G.
Geri.
You know, for years, my husband Geri, it's Geri with a J, J-E-R-R-Y. My husband Geri and I, we were considered just an institution here in Shad. Well, actually it may be that people thought we should be institutionalized, but it was something like that. Anyway, we certainly enjoyed our 20 years here in Shad, and community involvement was always very important to me. Why, I was very proud to serve on the Chatham Library Board, and I was thrilled to begin to bring the library murder mystery plays to Chatham. But when it came time to retire, Geri and I decided to move someplace normal. You know, like normal Illinois. And so when Linda Meyer said that the library was going to have a fundraiser, you know, for the sixth annual murder mystery play, well, I was just more than thrilled to hop on my bike and come down here. I hope that none of you are disappointed that there's no play here this year. But at least you're here to see some friends, old friends, maybe some new friends, and maybe some people that aren't so old. Besides, it really is more fun just to be here and have a party and to stop all that bloodshed and all that killing. So, and enjoy the free food. Well, actually, I was kind of surprised to find out how much the food costs. I think $50 you might take it here. I turned to Geri and said, Geri, what is this? Is this a local epic fundraiser? But Linda told me it was for charity, and that all the money that we received we used to purchase books. And I said to her, Linda, you're still using that old excuse? Well, we started that when I was doing murder mysteries. Actually, we never did buy the books that we said they were going to run to. I suppose I wasn't supposed to say that, was I? Oh, well. Anyway, it certainly is good to visit old friends once more. I feel like we're home again. Right, Geri?
Right, Geri? It's great to be back in Chatham again. It's like finding an old shoe. You know it's going to fit. I need a good smell. Leaving Chatham wasn't easy. You know, I can remember back that the town trustees, they were really divided on the issue of zoning, on how high the party sign was going to be. It was deadlocked. That was the biggest thing in Chatham at that time. Now Chatham has every fast food restaurant imaginable. I saw a restaurant the other day. It was Angus Burgers. And I remember when you couldn't find a place to park down by Fat Willie's. Fat Willie's down there, right? Right? Okay. Being a retired teacher, I did what I could to help out Chatham and the library and the fundraising efforts by taking part in these murder mystery plays. Well, I remember one year I got to play detective. And another year I got to play detective again. And you guess that the third year, detective again. You think I'm typecast or something? Maybe it's because I'm the only one that's got a trench coat. I wouldn't mind being typecast, but I heard that after I left, they made a detective some ditzy dame. I think she was just two French fries short of a heaven. Well, at least I haven't been as badly typecast as Cassie. Right, Cassie?
Yes, Geri, okay? I had to play characters completely different from my personality.
Yeah.
Yeah. This one year, let's see, I played this macho newspaper reporter. Oh, I was the murderer that year. Another year, I played Plain Jane, a single matron. I was a co-murderer that year. Let's see, then I played Charity Drive, another mannish character, murderer. And then I played, oh, let's see. Oh, director. I wasn't the murderer that year.
Patricks, who, by the way, are true village treasures. And just like treasures, it's kind of a miracle that they haven't been buried by now. I'm very old, okay? I just can't believe it. You know what? I'm done. I need to get out of here because that tipsy time is going to be coming this way, and she's going to be bragging. Oh, yeah. Oh, how she's been the alluring actress in all of these plays.
Oh, Kathy, you shouldn't be so jealous. Why, everybody knows you're the glue that holds these plays together.
Uh-huh.
And you know, it's only fitting that you're the glue, since you're just like an old nag who's been put out to pasture. Oh, it's just great to see all you wonderful people again who supported the murder mystery plays all these years. You know, when I heard they were going to have a reunion party, I thought they would probably be reprising some of their favorite characters. So, I told Stu Bed, I want to be Anna Nicole Smith. You know, a part I'm perfectly suited for. And the old fool said no. He said I couldn't be Anna Nicole because she wasn't one of his characters. Oh, that Ed. You know, he just walks around here like he owns the place. Just because once he was library board president, he just walks around here like he thinks he owns this place. You know, if he was so darn important, you would have thought that he would have ran for something a little more prestigious, like, oh, I don't know, Chatham Poison Hotline Control President, instead of walking around here like he just thinks he owns this place. Oh, he just thinks he owns this place. But, well, anyway, I'm really confused. Anyway, he thinks he just owns this place. Where was I? Yeah, he thinks he just, oh, you know what? I really shouldn't complain. Oh, no, it's a much better idea than doing a play. At least for once, I don't have to be mesmerizing all those lines. You know, I would just like to make a toast to the Chatham Library, you know? May you always have hopes and stuff like that. And may people always want to be reading, because without reading, well, there would just be books. There wouldn't be no books, because then there'd just be words, and there wouldn't be any place to put them. Oh, and so I'd like to make a toast to the citizens of Chatham. May you always be citizens until you no longer are. And finally, to the citizens of Chatham, may you always be reading. Thank you. Oh, God. Oh, God. Just be done.
Hello, everyone. I really didn't want to come here today. I'm not very good around crowds of people. My name, if you don't know me, is Al E. Mooney. I'm really sorry to have to take up so much of your time. When I'm in one of those plays, I get to be someone different.
An exotic British military man. Or a crazy chef man.
But when I have to be myself, I just don't like to be seen in public. This is who I am. Quiet, shy, and a bit of a loner. My psychiatrist said I should appear in the play. She said it would be a lot cheaper than group therapy. Judging from the actors who come back here year after year, I think their reasoning must have been I'm in his shadow, I just scooch over a few inches and I can see again. He used to be a high school principal and a teacher, just like the Attricks. In fact, Jerry Attrick was my teacher, my inspiration for going into teaching. I figured if Mr. Attrick can teach, certainly I can do that too. So I apologize again for taking up so much of your time. I really don't like being in settings where I attract attention to myself. I really don't like parties. In fact, okay, I really don't like people. So I'd appreciate it if you don't talk to me at all. If you see me in the buffet line or getting something to drink, I would really appreciate it if you would just walk on by and leave me alone. In fact, it would be great if you just got up and left now. You're making me sweaty.
Hello, everyone. I'm Mark in Time. I was only been in one play, and I didn't even have any lines, so I'm not really sure why I've been invited to this reunion. Hello, everyone. I'm back. Yes, it's clearly in charge. I know that I haven't been able to be in the last few plays, but I see more clearly. Apologize to my adoring public. You see, when you lead the life of a busy optometrist, do we call us? I've been very busy examining eyes all over town, and it's because of me that people everywhere can see. Oh, sure. I was never able to get the village trustees to see beyond their noses, but alas, with every success comes some failure. But I couldn't keep all you wonderful people waiting any longer, and that's why Linda Meyer asked me to come to the library to help throw a party to celebrate the 6th anniversary of the library murder mysteries. I was the guest of honor. How could I? To be honest, I've heard that the last few plays without me have been pretty amateurish. In fact, I heard that the clues kept getting easier, the dialogue was staying. The only reason they keep doing the plays is because the library bought the complete series of Harry Potter books. And they're just trying to cost justify it. But really, I need to thank Stu Gary for making me a household name in this town. Why, people still come up to me and say, look, it's clearly in charge. But wait a minute.
I think about it. They're clearly in charge here. It wasn't his idea, but mine. Now, I guess I don't need to thank Stu Gary for anything. In fact, he's just some two-bit hack writer who thinks he's Chatham's answer to Shakespeare. But in fact, he doesn't even live in Chatham. Who keeps inviting him back? Well, forget about him because it's clearly in charge now.
Hey, y'all. Sure is mighty nice to meet you. I've never seen so many people before. It makes the body nervous to know that y'all can't show your appreciation for all that library play acting stuff you've been seeing all these years. Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to be rude or nothing. My mama whooped me before my manners. My name's Stu. Stu Head. You probably already know me as Ken Guy Funny, writing these things for the library all these years. You know, I thought that'd be pretty easy. I'd have been done in case it's easy. I've always been good with words and stuff like that. But dang, it's been hard trying to figure out who done better than the bad guy each time. It just done stumped me more than the log most of the time. So all I done really is I watched TV. I wrote down what happened on that show, Quincy. I sure do like that Quincy. How messy he is as Felix. So that's what I done the first time. I just wrote down what happened. And then he came back and wanted another one. So I just changed the names. Did it again. And again. And again. Till here we are here 6 party times later. You know, I don't mind doing this play acting stuff. It gives me a chance to see that pretty Cassie Nolan. She's a mighty fine lady. Not like that tipsy. He's just a harlot. She's kind of scary. Quincy, I sure do. He yells at all the bad people. He ain't a scared of no one. I likes Cassie. I think I was going to ask her to marry me. I likes Cassie.
Well, now when that deliverance meets Forrest Gump, I mean, that really touches your heart right here, doesn't it?
Oh, hi, by the way.
I'm Pat Arco. Just like Dr. Clearly here, I've been absent the last few plays. But I was sure glad that we had this reunion and I could come back and just get together with all my long-term friends, talk with everybody that I know and relate and stuff. Even the people here pay. But, you know, I thought I'd enjoy retirement. I was gonna just sit in a big old easy chair, look out the window. Overlooks, yes, the mighty crystal clear waters of the mighty San Juan River. But you know, I'm really glad to see that my son Al is taking up where I left off. You know, I really worried about that boy. I really did. You know, he just doesn't quite right in the head. I think that's his mother's side of the table. Anyway, I thought that for him to be in these plays, he'd be a little bit more normal. But I guess that was a pretty stupid assumption on my part, wasn't it? I mean, since when has the library ever been associated with anything that's normal? Where else are your tax dollars used to download the Sports Illustrated swimsuit issue? Except the state or Glenwood High School? No, anyway. Quite frankly, you know, I'm really surprised they didn't make me come and be in all the plays that I missed. I mean, they just keep asking me back. I've been trying to get out of these plays for years. And then Lynn Meyer threatens to double my fines. Anyway, one year, you know, they know I've got medical issues, and what do? Oh, they just keep asking me back. I broke my hip. So what do? They write a party. With a cane. I mean, geez, I'm still going through therapy for that. Then I had heart surgery. What do? They make me come back. I mean, I'm still in recovery at that time. I mean, what's a guy got to do to get out of being one of these plays? Die?
Like Well, I think it's about time to get the doctor in here and declare him dead so we can get on with this party. I promise you, I will not be staged.
Everyone. A lot of dessert ordered for this today, and frankly, if any more people die, we're going to have a lot of dessert left over. I'm pretty sure the paramedics will be around shortly to get these bodies out of the way, but in the meantime, why don't the rest of you take a short break? And the desserts are over here, so we'll send you out like a buffet line, and grab some food, get something to drink, come on back, think about what you've seen so far. And we'll take, we do another 30 minutes, shorter?
About 10, 15 minutes.
Yeah. Just relax and enjoy yourselves, and if anybody else dies, I'll let you know.
His isn't even as big as mine, I tell you. But I'm sorry, everyone. I forgot. Last year, I pretended.
Congratulating them and saved a whole lot of money, and it's certainly been less deadly. You know, when we first had the idea of doing murder mysteries, I had something really grand in mind, you know, like murder on the Orient Express. So what did we get? We got Stu Ped's notion of murder at the murder mystery play. Oh, I tell you, I've seen better plots at Scooby-Doo. Now, the truth is, we didn't just move to Normal, because we had to flee there. I was run out of town by the library board. They said these fundraisers were giving the town a bad name, as if in any town where Tom Gray is the mayor, it would be easy to do. I do miss my old friends so much. Really looking forward to visiting them. And now we're going to have to spend our time caught up in a double murder investigation. Let's be honest, no one ever intentionally died here at the library. Except Gene Scott, who was a former trustee, ran into Stu Ped's pitchfork. Ran into it 10 times. I swear, that Stu Ped is the cause of my having to leave my dear friends. I swear that Stu Ped, he'll get what's coming to him.
I agree with you, Jerry. I never wanted to move away. I miss our adopted hometown. I miss watching all the traffic problems on Walnut,
I miss this quaint shops like Casey's. Pups. Dollar General. I miss debating the leaf burning issue with every all the neighbors in the neighborhood. I know that Jerry wanted to blame the author for our misfortune, but I have to be the honest. The real culprit is someone else. You see, maybe none of you remember, but years ago I was the original detective in these murder mysteries. But one year, a different person took my place. He bombed. Pat Farr. He was insanely jealous, too. He started spreading rumors about Jerry and I, trying to say that the old-timers were the ones that were responsible for the explosive growth in Chatham, when everybody knows it was the library's fault. After all, they constructed this grandiose building and needed somebody to justify the building. Besides, doesn't it seem a little suspicious that both victims are related? I can understand Pat being killed. Let's be honest, he had lots of enemies. But Sarah? She was a nobody. The only one less important in this town than Sarah is the city manager, Dale McCord.
Listen, okay, I don't care who died, how, or really for what reason. Can't you see the writing on the wall? See, there's a 60% probability that I'm the murderer. Three out of the last five plays, I was the guilty party, okay? So, statistically speaking, I'm the murderer. You know what? I tried to seduce Pat years ago, okay? I'll admit it. But you know what? He didn't give in to my alluring allure. I couldn't believe it. And then I tried to seduce Al, okay? Yeah. He wouldn't give in to my female charms either. Can you believe this? I mean, most men can't resist my alluring allure. You know what? More men have passed through my doors than truckers at the Homestead truck stop. Actually, you know, many of them were truckers from the Homestead truck stop. Jackpot. You know what I mean? I must insist, okay? I'm the one being framed for this murder. It's quite obvious. Can't you tell that that stupid has some kind of perverse crush on me? Always casting me in these masculine roles. I mean, come on. He's framing me for the murder. You know, he'd make some Hollywood writer rich if the movie of his life hadn't already been made. It's called Goofy the Movie. This whole thing is kind of like a Disney movie if you think about it. All the reunion members are like the seven dwarves, and of course I'm Snow White. Being framed for the murder of Prince Charming and the evil stepmother. I don't know. You know what? Just forget the whole thing. I'm going to get to the bottom of this myself.
Isn't this supposed to be a reunion party? With cakes and drinks and cake. Imagine people are lying dead over there. Hey, is this a murder mystery play then? Oh, if it is, I'm going to be Anna Nicole. Oh, I'd be great as Anna Nicole. Look, everybody, I'm Anna Nicole. Outside, but no. Pat and that annoying Sarah. They always insisted on top billing. Every year, they always get the parts I wanted. Well, look who's dead now. Is it just a coincidence that they're dead and they have the parts I wanted? I don't know. I think someone should check their alibi. Just where were they when they were dead, huh? I think there's a big conspiracy going on here. Yeah. I haven't seen any cops, have you? I just wonder who bribed them to stay away. No. Oh, well, it really doesn't matter. Chatham Police Department couldn't solve a crime in a paper bag. Yeah, I guess it's up to me to find the murderer. And I've always said, if you're gonna do something yourself, you're gonna do something yourself.
Okay. So my wife and my dad are dead. Yes, that's the reset. But more importantly, I know what I'm thinking. You're thinking that since I'm related to both victims, that I must be the murderer. Am I right? Well, I'm telling you, it's not me. What you don't know is that my dad never liked my wife, and my wife never liked my dad, so it's pretty obvious. They murdered each other. Ah, you say to yourself, if he's not the murderer, then why isn't he sad? Huh? How come he's not distraught that his two favorite relatives are dead? Sorry, Mom. Well, that shows you what you know. I'm very upset. I'm practically beside myself with grief. Look at this. There's a ton of tears falling off this cheek. Come on, feel it. Well, it's hot in here. They're evaporating on impact.
That's it.
It's the heat. The heat. The real murderer turned up the thermostat in the library, knowing that my father's ticker couldn't handle it. And as for Sarah, she didn't bring enough fluids. Very crafty, if you ask me. So if you want to know who the murderer is, you need to see who knows his or her way around a thermostat. Am I right? Huh? So you see, everyone, I'm sure that you want to blame me because I'm such a people person. But that doesn't mean that I was jealous of all the attention that they were getting. I didn't care that they each got their own private dressing room, while I had to share one with Bertha, and clearly in charge. If you want to find the murderer, you need to look for someone who really wanted his own dressing room. Am I right? Huh? Am I right?
Someone needs to restore some order. All my reunion friends have been running around out here, either scared that they'll be considered a murderer or ready to blame someone else. Please. With all these accusations, we're at the village board meeting. But let's just take a minute and calm down and take a look at things logically for a second. What do we have? Two murder victims? Okay, at a school board meeting, that's no big deal. But at the library, well, I guess that's no big deal either. But take a look at the location of the bodies. See, we draw a straight line from one body to the other, and then go to the midpoint of the two bodies. Now, if we draw a line from the midpoint gentlemen, I think we have found the murderer. Tell me, sir.
Where were you when the victims were?
What? That's one of the weakest alibis I've ever heard. It's clear that you didn't think that you'd be caught.
Stick around, sir. I'm sure that the authorities know how to talk to you.
And speaking of the authorities, I've taken the liberty of calling the local paramedics who will be here shortly to help dispose of these poor, unfortunate souls. And just to assure you that I'm completely blameless, I'll tell you right now that there's no truth to the rumor that I threatened to kill both Pat and Sarah yesterday. In fact, I didn't kill anybody yesterday.
This sure is puzzling. I ain't never done no soccer like this before. All these dead bodies. This body kind of confusing. I don't know what happened here, but everybody doesn't think they've been killed. Maybe it could have just been an accident. You know, this Pat Armoni, he's mighty, mighty, mighty old. Sarah here. Well, Sarah. She's just nasty. She's just liking herself a bit too much with all her fancy jewelry and fancy shoes. She might just die for being too prideful. I heard that could happen to a body. Body's being too snobby, huh? But not like that Quincy. He's not prideful. Sure, he live on a fancy boat, but he don't brag about it. He's not prideful like that at all. He's just a smart guy. So I don't know why all them actors people want to blame each other for doing the killing. Even Cassie wants to blame me for doing the killing. I guess she just don't know me. I done want to be your boyfriend. I done love her and want to marry her. I guess she just ain't thinking too straight with all them dead bodies up there. I don't know why I should do that. Figure out what happened to her. Quincy was here. He'd know what to do. You know, I tried to call him on the phone one time. He don't answer. I think maybe that Felix just didn't want him caught talking to anybody. I think he's just jealous. That's what I think. What should I do here? You know, I don't have any fancy medical code or any cool spyglass or anything like that to look for anything. Wait. I got some powdery stuff, you know, like they put around, the police put around to check for fingerprints. I could do that. I could put this, sprinkle this around and see what they can do, see what I can find out here. Oh, this is just that stuff you put on Frenchy toast, you know, even if it doesn't work, tastes awful good.
My glasses? I'm as blind as a bat without my glasses. But can't you see what's going on here? Everybody who's been invited to this play has had an important part to play. Either they've had big acting roles, or they've been the director or the writer, but I ask you, why am I here? Well, I'll tell you why I'm here. Someone is looking to frame me for the murder. It makes sense. Someone wanted these two out of the way, but didn't want to frame any of the other actors because the murderer needs them to be in the next play. But if I were the one sent to jail, who would miss me? The play can go on as usual. I would investigate these murders myself, but I can't find my glasses, and without them, I'm as blind as a bat. But it's clear someone invited a minor character here like myself just so I can take the fall.
Deader than a doornail. Or a flashlight battery in a thunderstorm.
We can get to the bottom of this, being the star detective that I am. Paramedics will be here shortly to remove the bodies, and so we won't have to watch it much longer. They're pretty busy today, though. They had a call out to the KC Hall Bingo, the dead body out there. And there's two more down at the Park District fundraiser that they got to pick up. And dead minister over to Lutheran Church, you know, it's chilly supper, you get him. But we got more bodies than anybody, so we're going to get more publicity. So head count does count around here. Since we just called the paramedics, we didn't call the police because we thought you all could figure out, you know, who the person is. I guess fundraising and chatter just doesn't mix. I think we can handle this, as I said, ourselves. And with my experience playing detective and having my nice coat here, there's no problem. Let's just sort of take a look at some of these sort of spiffs. See if we can come up to any conclusions here. See if we get any more pockets here. Check out. Let's get our pockets full. Eye drops. Ooh, that stings. Maybe we can make some sense of these clues and figure out who the murderer is.
Just a minute, Jerry. Wait, okay.
Okay.
Isn't that odd? Can't everybody see that he conveniently, you know, examined past Bonnie, but
yeah,
he seemed
yeah.
to have skipped over the other victims.
Okay.
The victim. Mark doesn't really count. Okay. So, Sarah, obviously, let's see. Who has been murdered the most times? Me. Who has been murdered? Who's been in the most plays? That's me. I'm going to take a look. Okay, let's start. Oh, look.
busy all afternoon.
Wow, hi, boyfriend.
I'm putting out a body bag today.
Hi, Cassie.
Hi, Cassie.
Hi.
Hi.
Hi,
Jeff.
Hi. Are you all that talented?
All the time. See, it's Saturday, so we're doing it.
applause. Thank you, boys. All right, we've got to get back to this. Okay, let's see. The bus ticket to Normal. Hello, we all know that they're the only ones from Normal. You think you could explain that? This is surprising that nobody else is from Normal.
Amazed more people haven't moved there. Truth is, I hate challenges. I've always hated it. The past 20 years that I've lived here, I hated it. That I couldn't get out of this godforsaken town fast enough. All of the... There's nobody that I, in Chatham, that I really consider to be my friend. You know, all of these old-timers whining about the newcomers and all their fancy restaurants and stores and that kind of thing. And then all of the newcomers, they whine about the old fogies that are here. They can't tell an ATM from a McDonald's. You ever see somebody trying to punch in their Big Mac order into the ATM keypad? They're said, yeah, I just wanted to get out of here and never come back. And in fact, the only reason we stayed here as long as we did was that Jerry got caught up with a bookie. And in order to get before to pay off the bookie, we had to run some bets for the bookie on all of these plays. Now, people would bet on Cassie Noble will get it in the second act, or Tipsy Time in the third act. And we never could get Stu Pett to do those scripts the way we needed to so that we could do this. Well, then finally, Ceremony died in the first act. And we made a killing. Well, I mean, you know what I mean. It was just way of speaking, we made a killing. And then we were gone for good. And I say, good riddance. You say you want to know the truth about Ceremony? Why she had a bus ticket to Normal? Well, you must know she was coming up there to stay with us. She was afraid of her husband, Al. She said he'd been acting real strange lately. Although it's kind of hard to tell when he's acting strange. And she was convinced that he was going to murder her. So we offered her a safe place to stay, where he wouldn't be able to find her. She bought a bus ticket, but we told her to turn it back in. That we were going to be coming down here for the reunion, and she could ride back on our motorcycle with us. Well, she's in a happier place now. She's not here.
I'm sorry to bother Gordon enough to leave all that money. In fact, I find it embarrassing. All that money. All it will do is attract attention to me. I'll walk into a store and people will stare at me and look at me and expect me to buy stuff. I can't handle that attention. I can feel my underarms getting damp. Calm down now. Focus. Go to your happy. That's better. No, I'm going to donate all that money to charity. Maybe I'll give it to the Chatham Historical Society. I hear that they're trying to get landmark status for Car Wash City Car Wash. As for Sarah wanting to hide in Normal for fear I would kill her, that doesn't make sense to me. I was always doing whatever I could to make her happy. She was always buying fancy dresses, purses, shoes. I didn't care. I want her to have anything that would make her happy. On a teacher's salary, I really couldn't afford all that expensive stuff. That's why I had to work two jobs. I worked nights at the dock unloading crates from the cargo boats. Okay. Chatham doesn't really have a dock. It's more like I was picking up trash around the wildlife sanctuary. But it's honest work, and it helps pay the bills. Look, I really gotta go now. All you people staring at me. I think I might wet my pants.
I just can't stand all these people just up and down in front of y'all. Maybe they may kill on purpose. Maybe I'll be the next one to get done in. I don't know what to do. God, it's just like that time with Quincy. You know, Kilter, he was getting close to catching the Kilter, and the Kilter almost killed him. But nah, Quincy's too smart to let Kilter kill him. Maybe I was a smart guy, too. Maybe I can stop the Kilter before he kills me. At least have to stop the Kilter before he kills my almost bride, Cassie. If I let the Kilter kill her, that'd make me sad. First, I need to tell y'all, I don't know nothing about that script that was on Pat Armoni. I didn't give it to him. But sure, I wrote him out of the script. I wrote him out because he was never saying the words I wrote it for him. He was always making up stuff about the mighty banks of that Sangamon River. I never did like that river. I never catch nothing. Never catch nothing out of that water at all. I likes Cassie. I'd never kill her because she's too nice. Not like that tipsy. I'd pay never no mind if somebody killed her. Hey. Well, maybe she's the one that's been doing the killing everybody all this time. Maybe she deserves to be dying herself. She better watch out, because you just never know when you go up and die and there ain't no Quincy around to figure out who done it to you.
Now, it's time to restore some sanity. After all, we've listened to a lot of lame excuses. People who are not in charge, like I am. Now, how do we know that Jerry and Cassie did a proper investigation of the crime scene? Jerry, the former newspaper owner, whose, what, biggest scoop was finding out that town's garbage pickup was going to change from Tuesday to Monday? And Cassie, whose biggest investigation was finding out how many Catherines there are in the house she's listing for. Give me a break. So, I'm going to take charge of this investigation, but first, let me clear the air about a few things. First of all, I was very jealous of Pat, Sarah, and yes, even that Mark and Time fella. In fact, I was jealous of everybody. You see, I wanted to be in the last several plays, but they kicked me out and wouldn't let me in. They said I was getting too popular. I don't know where you got that idea. And that the audience only wanted to see me. But I guess then it's only more fair to say that they were all jealous of me. They all conspired to keep me out of the plays because they were afraid of clearly in charge. So every year, I had to sit back and watch all the talentless people be cast in these plays. It was clear that they couldn't hold a candle. And I decided then, just to mess in their minds. Oh, I didn't kill anyone.
Yes. I changed the prescription of cat's eye drops to a powerful irritant. And, yeah, I took Mark's glasses and hid them. But I don't know how they could have ended up with Sarah. But you don't need 20/20 vision just to see that someone feels threatened by my presence here today. Someone obviously feels that my return to the library is going to be easy. They'll be bumped off in the cast. Make room for me. Well, ladies and gentlemen, all the applicant really wants to be clearly in charge.
Oh, yeah, you're a tool, all right. Oh, but not you people. Oh, I love you all. For you are my best friends. For without friends like you, there would be no place. And that would make me damn sad. Send in the cloud. There are to be clowns. I'll tell you who a clown is. Those actors come flying in here like they own an airplane. Well, I'm not buying it for 1 second. Who invited them to this party anyway, huh? Anyone been able to answer that little question? That. Who invited any of you here today? I didn't. Was it you?
I invited everybody.
Well, I won't ask you. It was her.
Double gloves.
we got to get to the bottom of this. This has just got to stop right now. So we're going to take a little break here. We're going to hand each one of you a arrest report, and we're going to ask you to write down who did it, and what the motive was, and how it was done. And we'll have, they said they got a little refreshments for you too. So we'll hand these out now, and then we'll pick them up. And I'm sure you all have a terrific idea of who had the motive, who had the opportunity. So we'll get these out now. Okay, well, it's inconvenient here at the end. I get some very wonderful arrest reports here. I'll just read you a sampling so give you an idea. The murderer, Seymour Clearly, motive, because he was in charge. The weapon, the glasses. The murder, Dupin. The body, because he was jealous of their lifestyle. The weapon, horse tranquilizers. Now this one, I'm not going to read the whole thing because it's a whole book. Dupin killed Tipsy Time and Peller Money. Sarah Money killed Mark Time. Tipsy kills Sarah. That's as far as I'm going to go now. As you know, I've been protecting the Measly Place, and I've always been calm and faced with adversity. However, I realize that because I'm the one the least likely to be killed, it's only natural you think I did. But I'm not to kill her. And I put my crime-solving skills to work here, and I figured out who did it. The murder is...
Stay calm. Stay calm, everyone. Don't you see? Killer's pattern? Someone has been killed in each act of the play. Okay, in the first act, two people were killed, but the first one must have been for practice. Now, the fourth victim, or the fourth act, the fourth act victim has died, but the rest of us are safe. I know it's not me because it's only a question of time before they beg me to be in the plays again. So now I'll just take over the investigation. Yes, it's clearly in charge.
Aha! More and more people are dying who aren't related to me. Am I right? So I couldn't possibly be the killer, could I? Of course I knew about the insurance policies taken out by Dad and Sarah. I was the one who encouraged them to do it. But I didn't kill them because of it. Well, actually, I didn't have a chance. Somebody beat me to it. But I thank them just the same. Just because I wanted to kill them, that doesn't make me a murderer. Am I right?
Two of us left.
I know it wasn't me. You know, I told you that Sarah feared for her life. She was going to try to escape to normal. But she never had a chance. Neither did any of these other poor souls. So, if it isn't me, it has to be Stu Pitt.
No.
I'll get him. Last thing I do.
This don't make no sense at all. All them play actors are dead. I'm not. I wish I'd known what's been going on here. This is like WWQD.
What would Quincy do?
I bet y'all done things I killed everybody because I was the one that's been ciphering all these plays all the years. But I never did tell anybody something wrong. I didn't write none of them plays. You'll find this hard to believe, but that's just too much smart stuff for me. No more tips. Someone sends me the words in the mail, name on the author in line, and I just turns them into the library. I wish I'd known what's been going on here. I wish I'd known who's ciphering these plays. If I could figure that out, I bet you I could figure out who the real killer is. I just can't think. My brain hurts. I just can't think.
Remember, she was babbling something about feeling relaxed. Her muscles were so relaxed. When she was in the back, I put an electrical stimulation machine on her. She was so out of it, she thought I was giving her a massage. Only I soaked the pads in poison. Finally, everybody else who died, I also have trained skills in acupuncture. So, as each person got up to speak at the end, I shot a tiny poison needle at each one. That was just like I had Alyssa Holmes do that, kill that innocent audience member in the Murder at the Murder Mystery play a few years ago. So you got to see a rerun. Oh, that reminds me. Everything you thought about all the other plays was mistaken. I was the one who murdered or caused to be murdered the victim every year. So all you fools who won the prizes the last 5 years, you got to give them back. And if you think I did it alone, you're wrong again. I had an accomplice all these years. Isn't that right, Paula Stott Pope? So, with everybody dead, I officially declare this play deader than a doornail. Oh.
Where's Cassie?
I was just about to get that. You say, what about Cassie Nova? Well, that Cassie.
making sure he's pretty. I really do like that, Cassie.
Thank you all for coming.